At the 1 yard line, here's the kick with an east wind blowing today. It'll be taken by an up back. No, it's not. It kicks out of bounds. Larry Wright over on the far side. I don't know if he got a hand on it or not. I think he pulled back, so it went out of bounds at about the 6 yard line. They'll have the option of re-kicking or taking the ball at the 35, and likely will take the ball at the 35 yard line. So that'll be where we start this ball game. First down and 10, and they go out of an eye, which is unusual. And it will be the Tenoch play action from the 28. Throw deep over the middle. Everybody collides. The ball is incomplete down around the 30. It was intended for Chad Mackey. Single setback this time. Peter Ragsdale, they're going to throw out in the flats on the right side to Mackey behind the line of scrimmage. He will catch the ball at the 28. He'll move it across the, make it the 33, move it to the 37-yard line. He got two. Larry Walker on that reception. Single setback, three wide outs on the left side, and they'll set up a screen. Now they're going to throw a double pass, and they have just gotten the Aggies deep, and it'll be completed down to the 30. They threw it in the screen to a screen left. It was caught there and then thrown again and went down to the 31-yard line.
Just an outstanding play and well executed.
First down and 10 from the Aggie 31. Deep pocket at the 40. Throw the ball, caught inside the 20. This one goes to the 18, and that's caught by Chad Mackey. So first down and 10 at the 17-yard line. This is more like the 18. Single setback. They go on the ground for the first time. It's a nice hold. It'll take it down to the 10. That's Bobby Ray Tell. Tyler Lazane is the fullback, split backs, and Tell is the halfback. There's a flag. They throw. It's intercepted in the end zone, but they have blown this play dead. It was intercepted by Sean Horn in the end zone. They were trying to get the ball to Troy Edwards, and it was Sean Horn stepping in front of the ball.
But false start by Louisiana Tech. It'll back them up five and set up a second and about six.
Second down coming and six from the Aggie 15. Motion back toward the middle of the field. Straight drop, Mackey. Throw the ball. That's be Martin, rather. Throw the ball. Incomplete. Among others, we had Jason Webster check out, and Pat Williams is off the field on a third down. Back from the 25. Here is pressure. And a quarterback sack inside the 35, outside the 30 to the 32. Keith Mitchell just got his sack. They're going to spot this one down at the 36-yard line. The Aggie 36, hash to the right, angle to the left. So this would be a career long for him if he hits it. 45's his longest. Marty Kitt puts his foot into the ball. It's on its way. Did he make it? He did. That's a new career long.
That drive went 55 yards in eight plays. It started at the 35-yard line after the opening kickoff went out of bounds. The big play was on a third and eight, a double pass, a 32-yard completion from Jackson to Francis Figaro. The drive stalled, and Marty Kitt kicked a 46-yard field goal, his career long, to lead it 3-0.
There's the kickoff. It's going to go into the end zone and will be taken to the far sideline in the end zone and downed on a knee by Dante Hall. So the Aggies will have it first down and 10 at their own 20.
We're going to see a lot of running plays today out of the A&M offense, I believe. They'd like to control the football, control the clock, and keep this Louisiana Tech offense off the field.
On the ground to Parker as he looks for the left corner. He has five, he has six to the 26-yard line. Here's the second down play. Stewart behind center Collins. And they hand off to Hardam. He tries the middle, and he's going to get the 28-yard line. We'll be a yard and a half shy of a first down. Now a third down, a yard and a half. Hash mark to the left side. Again, one eye. Two tight ends and a flanker to the right. The open side of the formation. On the ground, we hit the middle. It'll be a first down carry by Sir Parker. Parker will get it just across the 30. It'll be a length of the football carry there that will net the first down. That's the initial first down for the Aggies. Motion from Connell. Straight drop by Stewart. We're going to throw in the flats. It will be caught at the 25 to the 30 to the 35. That's Parker fighting for the 40. He has the 40. It will be a half yard shy of a first down. Sir Parker, as they turn and threw out of the backfield. Second down play coming. Flanker to the right, tight end to the left. They're split in that direction. Here is the handoff. It's a pitch back to Parker looking for a block. Gets the sideline, and he'll punch it to the 44. And out of bounds he goes there in front of the Aggie bench for an A&M first down. Have its first and 10, Texas A&M. We send two wideouts on the left side of the formation. One's in the slot. The tight end Spiller's here on the short side. And the Aggs go with a light eye. They hand off. They hit the middle. It's going to be Parker. He has the 45-50. Has the sideline as he's bumped out of bounds at the La Tech 40.
That'll be Eric Bernard.
That's Bernard checking in. Byron Smith is a former high school teammate of the Aggies, Quentin Brown. And on the ground, no play action. Roll to the left, throw the ball. Dropped at the 35 by Hardiman. Aggies now in the ball game today have scored in 99 games in a row. Trying to hit the century mark in this one. Split backs. Ball's at the 41. It's second down and 10. Hash mark to the right side. Stewart takes it, and he hands off Bernard. They're looking for the left side. Has a man at the corner. He beat him 45-30. And side the 30, and he trips and falls forward to the 28-yard line. They're back to the line of scrimmage. Two wideouts coming in this direction. That's it's Hodge in the slot to the right. Tight end Spillers on the left. The wideout is Hawkins. And the handoff goes to Bernard. He has a chance to score, and he will. Got a block at the 25, and he takes it in 28 yards. That is Eric Bernard, his third touchdown of the season. Here's Kyle Bryant. He's 11 of 12 on extra points this season. Bill Johnston will be the holder. Light rain, very light mist falling here at Kyle Field on this October afternoon. Johnston waits for the snap from Kyle Lednecki. There it is, and he will spot it down, and it's through and true, and it's a 7-3 Texas A&M lead at the 9:16 mark. And 9:16 to go in our first quarter. And here's the kickoff, and it'll be taken about 3 yards deep in the end zone. They will return it. They'll take the knee. They'll bring it out to the 20. A&M looked at it. He committed early to Mississippi. Here's the play. They'll go to the fullback. That's going to be to Lazane at the 20, 25, and he is hit around the way down by the Aggies. Brandon Jennings, second down about 5.5 from their 24.5. They'll throw the ball. It's partially deflected by one of the Aggies, and I think it was Pat Williams, perhaps, that got a deflection. Single setback, either Ragsdale or Tell. Straight drop by Martin. Throws and goes to the sideline. That will be a first down. That's caught by Mackey, covered by Horn. First down and 10, 33.5. Slot to the left. They'll get throw out in the flats. The ball will be caught in the backfield and dropped at the 32. Nice play over there by the Aggies' Donovan Greer. 8 minutes to go in the first quarter. The Aggies, there's movement on the left side to tie it in. That's Bradley, moved, thinking the ball had been snapped, but it had not. So here we go. They move them back by 5 yards. Now the ball's inside the 30, back at the 27, and on the ground it goes, and it's Tal, and he's hit at the line, got a yard, and that's it. And now a third down. Scoreboard says 16. They will need to get it out to the La Tech 44-yard line, and they go from a shotgun. There's movement, and I think that perhaps La Tech has been caught with a illegal procedure. Back them up five more. The ball now inside the 25. It's about the 22. Again, they must punch it out to the 44 for a first down. Two wideouts left side, one to the right. Single setback, shallow pocket. Flag is down. They throw to the sideline, and it's incomplete. They were trying to get it to Mackey near midfield. And now the meaning of the flag, which is back at the line of scrimmage. Illegal formation declined by Texas A&M. So they'll drop the flag on him. Here's the snap as they punt the ball, standing back at the 10. This will be David Lill, and the Aggies will take it to the 34. There's a flag down as the return from Hall gets it across the 50, back to the 44, Louisiana Tech side of the 50. Flag down where the catch was made at the 35-yard line. And they're discussing things down on the field. The punt went 42 yards.
Good. So the Aggies will get the ball on the Louisiana Tech 45-yard line. They will decline the penalty.
And here are the Aggies now on offense. It is Brandon Stewart with an I formation. They'll hand off to Parker. Parker across the line of scrimmage to the 42-yard line. Second down and 7. Aggs must get it to the La Tech 35. Straight drop. Stewart stops. Throws incomplete. That's off the hands of the tight end Spiller. Would have been enough for a first down had he caught it at the 34s. Third down and 7 from the 42. Single setback, slot left, flanker to the right. And it's a quarterback draw. Here's Stewart running with the ball, and he will be shy of a first down as he crosses the 40 and goes to the 37. Here is Leckler for the first time today. 15 kicks for the season. And a 38.1-yard average is the freshman redshirt out of East Bernard. Number 9 in the Big 12. And he's punted it high in the air, and it is going to make the end zone. Matter of fact, about 2 yards shy of the end line. It's La Tech's ball. First down and 10 at their 20. A single setback. Check him in a moment, and it will go to that setback. It'll be Ragsdale. He'll get about 3 yards. They try the middle. Second down and 7 from the 23. Mackey went in motion to the right side. Straight drop by Martin. Pressure from the backside. Throws as he is hit. It goes into the ground at the 25. And it was intended for Dean Jackson. Keith Mitchell just pressured the quarterback. Hit him right between the 1 and the 0. They were recognized before the game today. Deservedly so. Four defensive backs, or rather offensive receivers to the right side. They try a pass in that direction. It's knocked down. And now a flag is down. The line of scrimmage, the 23, apparently will be against La Tech, and the Aggies will decline and bring up fourth down. So it's fourth down, and apparently they will punt it away. David Lill, last punt was 42, standing at the 10. Line of scrimmage is the 23. Oh, this is a nice punt. Here is Hall backing up at the 25, looks for a return, got a block on that far side. Now he is being bottled up, got to the 30, retreats back to the 28. They'll give him the 30-yard line. A&M first stand 10 at their 30, and a light eye, and the handoff will go to Parker. He has a hole. He's got a chance. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. There's a man with an angle, pushes him out of bounds at the 28-yard line. John Knoll, the number two tackler, their free safety, the only man apparent at that time with a chance to get him. Slot to the left eye formation, first and 10 at the 28. He'll go on the ground again as Parker gets the handoff. He will make it to the 25 and a pickup of 3. Quarter eye formation, Hardiman, Bernard lined up behind him. Split in right flanker left, and it goes to Hardiman. He has the middle. He's got the 20. He's got the 15. He's down to the 11-yard line. First down, Texas A&M at the 11, first and 10. Aggies, by the way, now have scored in 100 games in a row, and they've scored in 144 home games in a row. Aggs first and 10 at the 11. Pitch it to the left. Parker looks for that block from Hardiman at the 10. He's fighting for the 5. He's tackled and brought down at the 5-yard line. Great lead block that time from Tiki Hardiman and John Knoll. Sir Parker, 336 yards into this game today. We'll check him again in a moment. We try the middle. It's Parker. He's caught at the 5, and he jersey tackle there, and then goes to about the 3 or 4. Here's the third down, and A&M needs about 3. Full house backfield. There was movement on the Louisiana Tech side of the ball. The Aggies have handed off as we try a sweep to the right to Hardiman. Hardiman gets it to the 2-yard line. That's not enough for a first down. I think that there may have been a La Tech defensive lineman in the neutral zone when the ball was snapped, so it'll be half the distance if that's the case. Two tight ends, Campbell and Mahone. The handoff will go to Hardiman. Hardiman has the first down. If he did not get the touchdown, he'd get the first down. He's not into the end zone. He is stopped at the lip of the cup, and it will be first and goal then at that point for Texas A&M. And that will be Williams as the fullback, and Hardiman is the tailback, and the handoff goes to Hardiman. Touchdown, Tiki. He was shut out last week for the first time this year, but he just scored that touchdown, which will be number 6. Kyle Lednecki is the Aggie deep snapper. He's out over the ball, spotted down by Bill Johnston, and Kyle Bryant's extra point is on the board. And A&M now leads it by a score of 14-3. We have 1:19 to go. And here's the kick. Be a low sailor. And will be picked up at about the 8. It's going to be a reverse. They're going back the other way to Jackson. Breaks a tackle at the 25. Breaks a tackle at the 30. Spins and goes to the 36-yard line. That was Edwards, rather. Troy Edwards on that return. So a first and 10 at the 35. And once again, here is Jason Martin. He's the quarterback. Takes the snap, drops back at the 25, and he's pounced on from behind by Keith Mitchell at the 25-yard line. Running back is set up as a halfback on the right side. Here is, and they're going to give it to the running back. And I think that time it's going to be Bobby Raytel, or is that Ragsdale? He'll check him. He picks up about 4 yards to the 30. Third down and 15. First play, second quarter. The Aggies lead 14-3. Shotgun. Deep pocket back at the 20. Throw the ball. It's caught, then dropped across the 30, about the 35, 37-yard line. A freshman, Dante Hall, back in anticipation of the punt from David Lill. Hall, number 4 in the Big 12 in punt returns, an 11.5 average starting today on 12 returns. Nice snap. Foots into the ball. Little wobbly kick. It'll be taken by Hall at the 28. To the 30, to the 35. Tripped up, he goes to the 37. So a 9-yard return by Dante Hall. Here's first down and 10 A&M. Primarily on the ground today. Not thrown yet to Albert Connell.
Now only 3 passes today total.
And Connolly is a flanker left. He's on the tight end side of the formation. Split out on the other side is Hawkins. Long count by Stewart, and on the ground again. Now this is an end around, and going back to Connolly's at the 40, 45, 50. He's got a chance. He is going to score to 62 yards. An end around. We got Brandon Stewart down there throwing blocks, 63 yards. And here is the extra point from Kyle Bryant. Johnston puts it down. His Lednecki snaps it to him, and the extra point is on. On the near side is Wright. On the far side, that should be Edwards. It's the first time that Connell has run the ball since the Alamo Bowl. He had a carry for 7 yards. That's the longest run of his career, 19 the earlier. And a yard deep. Wright's going to return to the 5. He's out to the 10. He misses. We had a missed tackle there. Now he gets it out to the 15, across the 15, about the 18. First down and 10. Louisiana Tech hash mark to the left side. They have the single setback. And they'll hand off. That goes to Tell. Tell's looking for the left side. He'll get about 8 yards. He gets close to the 25-yard line. Here's a second down and 3. Louisiana Tech. They have 2 tight ends and 2 flankers. Once again, Tell. He's 25, and that's all. Here's the third down play. It's a pitch coming to the right side. That's Ragsdale looking for the corner. He will have the first down. He is shoved into the A&M bench at about the 35-yard line. Their poorest offensive output this year was their first game against Middle Tennessee State when they had 366 yards. Their last 3 games, they have been over 400 yards a game. Play action. Here's Martin rolling right, throwing. Caught by Mackey at the 48, across the 50, and out of the Aggie 45. First down and 10 from the Aggie 45. Single setback, 2 tight ends again. 2 flankers, both sides of the ball. And the handoff will go to Tell. Tell about 3 to the Aggie 42-yard line. Second down and 7. Ball up the A&M 42. Hash mark left. Straight drop about 3 yards. Shallow pocket. Throw the ball. Caught by Edwards. A gain of 3 to the 39-yard line. To this point. Now they've gone back to Ragsdale, and they also have the fullback Lazane in the lineup. Martin may be calling an audible. Third down and about 3.5. Snap it. Drop back. Outside pressure. Throw the ball. It will be intercepted by Horn inside the 10 at the 8. Here comes his return to the 15, at the 20, at the 25, at the 30. And knocked out of bounds into the Aggie bench at the 35-yard line. About a 27-yard return for Sean Horn. So a turnover as they were driving. The Aggies have it at the 34-yard line. Play action. Stewart rolling right outside. Bashard will throw the ball through the hands of the first man, and that will be Michael Williams. The second man down deep was Albert Connell. By formation, slot right, split in left. Second down and 10. Stewart takes the snap, shallow pocket, throw it toward this sideline, and it will hit the back of the helmet of the defender on the play, Jonathan Maxwell, at the La Tech 40, intended for Hawkins. Hawkins and Connell will be sent to the right side of this formation. That's the open side. The setback is Bernard. Stewart drops back. Now he's under pressure. Now he will throw. It's a screen. They got a Bernard at the 40, at the 45. He's cut it back this way, at the 50, at the 40, at the 35, at the 30. Sideline. Out of bounds he goes as a flag will be thrown at the 20.
It'll be a first down.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Spot of the foul. First down.
Spot of the foul, a 10-yard holding call on Texas A&M. Here is first down and 10. The Aggies at the La Tech 32 on the ground. It goes to, hit in the middle and pushed back to the 35. Split back formation. Williams on the left side and Bernard on the right. 2 wide outs to the right. Now 1 in motion. It's Connell. Straight drop again by Stewart. Throw it out to the right side. Almost in. Oh, was caught by Bernard after juggling and almost went into the hands of one of the defenders at the 35. He's brought down. We end up losing 2 yards on that, but there was no interception. So it's third down, and they say 14, but more like 13. Single setback. Stewart takes the snap. Back at the 42. Dancing around. Moves around. Throws. In and out of the hands. And a flag will go down of the, that was in and out of the hands. Incomplete to the tight end Campbell. And they may get him for defensive pass interference. Myron Smith was there. Campbell had the ball. And in and out of the stomach.
That's
and
exactly incomplete. What they'll call.
So it's first and 10. A&M will show an I formation. Williams and Parker are the running backs. Stewart, the man under, looks to his left, says something, and now they snap it. It's a pitch coming back to the left side to Parker. One man falls down. Now he'll cut it down the field and will get a yard. Vautech's been scoring a lot of points this season, but they've been giving up a lot of points as well. And here's the play. It's play action. Deep pocket. Throw to the sideline. Incomplete. Trying to get it to Hawkins down around the 15-yard line. That sailed out of bounds. Slot to the right. Stewart's under center. Split in left. Straight drop. Stewart from the 34. Throws. It'll be the tie in at the 20. Will not be. Did he get enough for the first down?
I think he did.
He dove at the out of bounds marker. That's going to be Daniel Campbell. Campbell on the right there about the 18. I think he got the first down. Diving
yes,
for it, but Alexander says that the eye measurement's enough. It was first and 10, Texas A&M at the 17.5. Pitch it, coming left, short side of the field. That's Parker, cuts between, stumbles across the 15, and as he's stumbling, he has a nice gain to the 13-yard line. 7:55 to go in the second quarter. The Aggies with a lead here of 21-3 over Tech. Fifth time that the two have played. A&M 4-0 against this bunch. Eye formation again. And it's a straight-ahead handoff to Parker. Now he dances to his left. He'll get a yard to the 12-yard line on a second down and about 7. Playing that one in Manhattan. Kansas State's our next home game. Next week, the Aggies on the road in Ames against Iowa State. That ought to be a dandy ball game. Been moved up, by the way, to 11:30. Handoff. It'll go to Eric Bernard across the 10 to near the 7. Leroy Hodge to the right side. The Aggs with two tight ends. Hodge is a flanker. High formation. Stewart, let's see if he sneaks for it. Snap it, and Stewart will indeed sneak for it. He's got the first down at the 6. So it's first and goal. The ball has been moved to near the 6-yard line. Three tight ends, one in the backfield and an I formation. And it goes to Hardiman. He dives over the line of scrimmage at the 5, and he pushes himself down as he goes to the 2. Again, the full house backfield. The I formation, the ball at the 2, and the handoff. Hardiman dives. He's in for a touchdown. Hardiman just got touchdown number 7 for the season, number 2 today. And we'll give him 9 for his career. The extra point is good, and A&M now leads it 28-3. Over Louisiana Tech, and we are 5:32 to go in the first half of this ball game. We'll take a break here. Here's Kyle Bryant. Again, it'll be held on the tee by Donovan Greer. Approaches the ball, puts his foot into it, and will be taken by right at the 2, to the 5, to the 10, to the 15, to the 20, at the 22-23-yard line. And, boy, we got whirling dervish there. Bodies are flying all over the place. That drive now started at the Aggie 34-yard line. First down right. And 10 at the 23. Play action. Deep pocket. Throw the ball over the middle. Intercepted by Dat Wynn. Who dat? At the 34. He caught it at the 35. Tackled at the 34. First and 10. A turnover, and the Aggies have it. Handoff on the ground. Starts inside. Develops outside. 30. Hits it down. Now he's out of bounds. No, he did not go out of bounds. He's going to score. It's Eric Bernard. Bernard hit at the 20, and then he went on the tight rope on the near sideline. He just took it. 34 yards. Bernard gets his second touchdown of the day. Bernard has been over 100 yards one time. It's this year. 18 for 108 in the BYU game. 324 yards in total offense, Texas A&M in the first half. The extra point is on the board. A&M now leads at 35-3.
The Aggies lead at 35-3 at the 5:11 mark of the first half.
Wright and Edwards are the return men. Here is Kyle Bryant. Cruise kick right at the 4, the 10. Oh, they're going to hand off now. Coming back to Edwards. He will skip it across the 20. Now he's stood up and driven into the ground there by Texas A&M's Jason Webb. First down and 10. They give him actually the 21-yard line, so they gave him forward progress. They try to reverse, and it didn't work after the initial kickoff return. And here is the handoff in the backfield. It'll go to Ragsdale. Ragsdale to the 23. Second down and 8. Aggie defense spreading out to look at the formation thrown at him here on this play by Louisiana Tech. Straight drop, Martin throws. That was a timing pattern, and his timing was off, for it was the receiver, Edwards. Third down and 8, shotgun. Martin back to the 15, steps up, throws, caught by Mackey. He's caught and now brought down. He'll be shy of a first down at the 27-yard line. Shunhorn preceded by, among others, Terry Bradshaw, who played at La Tech. I guess you went against him a few times.
Too many times. He's good.
Here is Lil. He always punts a sailor. All the way back to the 17 goes Dante Hall. Here comes the return. He's across the 30, and he will take it to about the 34-yard line. Dante Hall. As we come back, Aggies have just broken the huddle and are coming to the line of scrimmage on a first down and 10 at the A&M 34. Split backs, and Stewart from a shallow pocket will throw to the far sideline. That'll be caught by the tight end Spiller, and he's rolled out of bounds with a couple of the La Tech defenders, one of which is Derek Parker, at the 40. Not enough for a first down. So the tight ends into play in this offensive game plan for the Aggies. Hand off in the backfield, the right half. Parker has a first down across the 45 to the 46-yard line. First down and 10, A&M. Count the first downs after this play. And here it is as they hand off to Hardeman. Has midfield and more across the 45, down to the La Tech 41, a first down. Adrian Fredericks made that stop. He went to the same high school as Bucky Richardson over in Baton Rouge in the backfield. Bottled up. Here is Parker looking for anything. It won't develop. He'll lose about a half a yard. A&M called time. Now they're at the line of scrimmage on second down and 10. The La Tech 42. Ash left, split back, straight drop. Pocket at the 49. Step up, throw the ball. Caught down at the 23. Across the 20, now to the 15 goes the tight end Spiller.
Beautiful throw by Brandon Stewart.
And on the ground, handoff Parker, leg tackle, and springs forward, then tackled from the backside for the Iowa State game. Players off the field, flags will fly as the ball is snapped. We just handed the ball off to Sir Parker. He was going to the left side on a second down, and scoreboard says 7. So a false start against the Aggies. Second down and 12. Ball moved back on the penalty. Outside the 15. On the ground, Hardeman starts inside. Now he goes back, and he broke a tackle. He's at the 5, and he scores. He started left, then went back to the right, then went left and then right, and he just scored from 16 out. Sixth touchdown of the day. Three of them, half of them by Tiki Hardeman. Scored on a 1-yard run, a 1-yard run, and now a 16-yard run. 8 touchdowns for the season. Here's the extra point, and it's good, and it's 42-3. Texas A&M with a minute 40 until halftime with the lead over Louisiana Tech. And now the kickoff. A&M leading at 42-3, 1:40 to go until halftime. Have dominated. They got a field goal on their opening possession. They've not scratched since. Here's the kickoff, and it's going to go right between the two return men, and now they'll pick it up, go down on a knee, and they whistle it dead, and it'll be brought out to the 20. And La Tech at the line of scrimmage, two wideouts left side, one to the right, single setback. Martin hands it off. Ragsdale across the 20 to about the 22-yard line.
Got some new defenders in there. Phillip Myers made that last tackle. Jimmy Irby, I see, he's played quite a Brad Crowley in at defensive line.
Out of the shotgun. They're going to air it out one more time, and here's a flag down. The ball is caught by Mackey, enough for a first down at the 31, and he's bounced into the sideline by Shun Horn. They waved it off, and they give him a first down. They waved him off and gave him a first down. So they'll give Mackey the reception at the 31-yard line. It stopped the clock at 106. So they ran on the first play. You think maybe they're going to run the clock out, but they've decided now to go back to the shotgun. Previous play from the shotgun from the 22 in the pocket. They throw to Mackey. Mackey again. From the shotgun, standing at the 40, drops back to the 35, takes a step forward, throws to Mackey again, goes to the Aggie 46. It's shy, however, of a first step. Shotgun again, line of scrimmage, the Aggie 46. Once more, they'll throw that out of the backfield. It's caught and dropped by Bobby Raytel. Third down and inches. Tight end went in motion. And they'll hand off to Ragsdale. Ragsdale gets the first down. They'll stop the clock to move the chains. Now 45 seconds to go. It's first down and 10. Louisiana Tech, again, the shotgun, pockets at their 45. They throw it to Jackson. That's Edwards, rather. Edwards will make the reception. Not enough for a first down. So here's the play. It's a second down and about 3 from the shotgun. Martin drops back to the 45, throws it. Mackey over the middle. He's down to the 25, cuts back at the 20. Caught from behind at the 20. Slides down with a man at his ankles at the 17-yard line. One timeout remaining in the ball game, the first half for the Bulldogs. Martin drops the shotgun, moves up under center, drops back now to the 20, lofts it to the end zone, caught, no, he dropped it. He trapped the ball, Mackey had it, and apparently trapped it as he went flying through the air at the goal line. Oh, the Louisiana Tech fans booing as they saw the replay on Jumbotron. It looked like Mackey caught that for a touchdown. Straight drop again out of the shotgun. They'll throw it out of the back. It goes to, that'll be Tell. Tell will get to the 10. There's not a whole lot there. Here's the third down play. 5 seconds to go. He's under. No shotgun. Drop it back to the 18. Under a lot of pressure. Throws incomplete. Two wideouts on the right side. Now they're moving somebody. That'll be Edwards, who had lined up on the right. They're moving with the short side of the formation. And the 25-second clock just ran out on them. So they, as they were moving Edwards right to left, they have a delay of game. They'll back it up to the 15-yard line. He has their only points today on a 46-yard field goal, spotted at the 22, angled back to the right from the left hash mark. David Lill, the punter, will be the holder. Snap, spotted down. The kick is on its way, and he just drilled it. So it's now at halftime, 42-6 on a 30. All right, and everything else will be later tonight. So Oklahoma State at Texas at 6 o'clock. Here's the kickoff of the second half. This one will sail to the back of the end zone and out of the end zone. Nice kick then by Marty Kent. So to the 20, the ball will come. And here are the Aggies on offense moving toward the south end zone. And we'll go on the ground. Now it's play action. And wide open here on the near side. That'll be Spiller to tie it in. Leaps over a man and is still in bounds and goes all the way out to the 45. A&M, that'll be the biggest lead at halftime. We have led one time this year at halftime. That was against UNT, 28-0. I'll check back here at least through the 93 season in a moment. Here's the handoff as we take it out of the backfield. It'll go to Parker. Parker across the 50 to the Louisiana Tech 49-yard line. In this one, Aggs are up 42-6. Here's a second down. We'll call it six, just across the mid-stripe field, mid-stripe mark here on the field. Ball favors the left hash mark. Out of the backfield, Parker again. Parker carries to the 44-yard line. That'll be close for a first down. William Mays.
That measurement showed that the Aggies were about an inch short of the first down, so it'll be third and quarterback sneak time.
All right, so third down. Stewart, two tight ends, flanker left and an I formation behind him. And no quarterback sneak. They'll hand off to Hardeman. Hardeman spinning. He goes to the 40. So Tiki will pick up the Aggie first down at the 40-yard line. First down and 10, the Aggies at the Bulldog 40. And it's play action. Deep pocket. Steps up. Throws over the middle. And it is caught. It's going to be Albert Connell. A touchdown. He caught it at the 10. He almost lost his balance, and he split two defenders, and he goes 40 yards on his first reception of the day. Connell on that one is going to go 498 yards for the season. That's his 37th reception of the year. He's well over 1,000. He's now over 1,100 yards for his career. And here is the extra point attempt by Kyle Bryant. Lednecki snaps. Johnston puts it down, and the extra point is on the board. And now A&M has made it 49-6. And now Bryant checking over the kickoff unit. Here he goes. And it's a cruise kick. It's an end under end. Far side at the 3 will be right. And they have just tried the end around again, and it's going to go to Edwards, and Edwards takes it out to the 25. Single setback, two wideouts to the left side. The tight ends in that formation as well. They're going to go on the ground, and out of the backfield will come Ragsdale across the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Here on the near side, Jackson and Edwards. On the far side will be Mackey. Shotgun from the pocket at the 25. Throw it. Ball batted up in the air, and it's been caught by Wynn. He's got a chance to score. He's at the 5, and Dant's got his second interception of the day and his first career touchdown. Randy South points out in a hurry that Dant indeed did have a onside kick that he picked up and returned for a touchdown on a squibbler that was picked up. Here's the extra point, and it's good. So that's his second career touchdown. He has two interceptions today. That's 1-2 in his career. And the Aggies have just made it 56-6. They are up by 50 points. Rich Cody has three interceptions for the season. Dant now behind him at two. That one he returns for a touchdown. Kyle Bryant Squibber is coming back to the near side. Picked up by an upback at the 30. Back to the 39-yard line. The ball will come. Eddie Jasper, Pat Williams, Brandon Mitchell.
They've got all the starters out there.
There is Donovan Greer. Cody is calling a signal here for Greer as he goes to the left side of the formation. From the shotgun, from the pocket at the 32. The ball is going to be caught at the 35. And there's Figueroa. Figueroa gets a first down. He takes it into Aggie territory. First down and 10. They operate now at the Aggie 40. Pocket back at the 48. Throw it. It is caught and then dropped. It's incomplete. That ball was caught by Jackson, and then he was hit. A good lick by Warwick Holman. A&M and Louisiana Tech, 12:05 to go in the third, and the Aggies lead 56-6. Martin, again a deep throws to Mackey on the sideline. He will be knocked out of bounds inside, outside the 30. Third down, very short. They have a tight end lined up in the backfield, and they will hand it off. And drop back at the 35 is Ragsdale. They had a sweep to the left, and the Aggies snipped it out. It's a fourth down and 5. Martin, I thought he was going to set up in the shotgun, but now he calls an audible. He moves up to the line of scrimmage, snaps the ball, drops back to the 42, throws to the right side, caught by Mackey on a fourth and 5. It'll be good for a first down. He got 7 on that. Donovan Greer wrapped him up. Here's a first down and 10 at the Aggie 28. And they have thrown to Mackey on this sideline. He has just fumbled the ball, and A&M has picked it up. That's going to be Jimmy Irby, who has picked it up and recovered it. McCowan has played once earlier this season. Rushed 5 times for 8 yards. Attempted 5 passes, completed 3 with an interception for 37 yards. So he now runs the Aggie offense. The handoff is in the backfield. We'll lose a yard there to the 34. Line of scrimmage to the 36. Gomea Cooper. Handoff went to Bernard. So Bernard wrapped up behind the line. Calvin Collins out of the lineup. Rex Tucker is the only change in the offensive line. He's out over the ball. He's the center. Split backs almost dropped the snap from center, and we hand off in the backfield. There is a mix-up there, and that's going to get the line of scrimmage, and that'll be all. A third down and 12 for A&M. Split backs once more for Randy McCowan. Tucker, the center, takes it, drops back, flags, whistles, stop the play. No development here. 5-yard mark off against A&M, so we're going the wrong direction on this possession as we made some changes. However, only at quarterback for the most part.
Well, Leroy Hodge has come in now, and Hardeman has gone out. We've got 3 wide receivers in the game.
And the only running back is Bernard. Snap it, pocket at the 20, trying to set a screen up. Now chased McCowan all the way back to the 10-yard line. They're going to wave the flag off, and they'll call it an incomplete pass. They said there was somebody, I guess, Dave, you said Bernard.
Eric Bernard.
Checks in to punt the ball away. Standing back at the A&M 14. There's pressure coming up the middle. Oh, he just got his foot into this one. Fair catch being called for. And A will be taken at about the 18-yard line. Time is 9:21 in the third quarter. A&M leads Louisiana Tech 6-6. And Jason Martin is back at quarterback. First down and 10. They go on the ground, and that will be Bobby Raytel. Bobby Ray will get it to the 21-yard line. Second down and 8. Raytel stays in as the running back, slot right. Straight drop. Martin throws, caught at the 24, and knocked down immediately at the 24. And that goes to Spencer Hurd, and that's the first time we've called his name today. 2 wideouts left side, single setback, split into the right. And again, Martin from about an 8-yard pocket throws it over the middle. It'll be caught by Edwards. Breaks a tackle at the 35. Goes to about the 41, 42-yard line. That was a nice pass and then a good run after the reception. 7:53 to go in the third. A&M 56-6 over Louisiana Tech. Single setback again. It's going to go on the ground. Raytel caught for a moment. Got away. Caught again. Got away. Goes to the 47-yard line. That was a nice run. Aggie defense, number 1 in rushing defense in the Big 12. Number 10 in pass efficiency defense. And it's a draw out of the backfield. Again, Raytel fighting for a first down, and he's going to be close as he takes it across the 50 to the 49, about a half a yard shy. This will be the first road loss this year for La Tech. They'll be 2-1. They'll go break even at 3-3. Here's the third down play. On the ground, they have the first down. Big hole left side across the 45 down to the 40-yard line. Will go Bobby Raytel. First down and 10, shotgun. Louisiana Tech from the 50. Step up, throw, and it is knocked away. Intended for Edwards at about the 10. Second down and 10, the ball at the 40. Ashmark to the left side. They have a slot to the right, a flanker left. The tie it in is inside the flanker. And the handoff is a draw to the backfield, and it's Tell again. From the 40 to the 35 he will go. Third down and 5. Ball just outside the 35-yard line. They need the 30, does the Bulldog offense. And Martin takes the snap out of the shotgun. Pocket at the 45. Steps up, throws high over the head of the intended receiver, Edwards, at the 25-yard line. It goes incomplete, and there is a flag down in the defensive backfield.
Generally a holding call because I didn't see anybody hit the quarterback. Whoops. Yep. Was that chop block?
Yep. Yeah. The ball on the penalty has been moved back inside the 45-yard line of Louisiana Tech. The 43 is the line of scrimmage, and they will throw to the far sideline high over the head of Mackey. That was a third down and a bunch, 27, matter of fact, incomplete. They came into the game today. They were a minus one in turnovers. The Aggies a minus 7. But that figure has been reduced. And here is the punt by Lil. It's a high one. Line of scrimmage was the 43, and he kicked that out of bounds. That hit on the track about halfway between the field and the stands down around the 20-yard line. Back out on the field. We've made a bunch of changes now in the offensive line. We'll go on the ground, and we try the middle. The ball looked like it for a moment might have been fumbled, but out to the 35-yard line. There's a whole bunch of folks there. That was Dante Hall. Hall has checked in, and he and Williams are the running backs. And let's see, you said, well, Kobe Agrak. So that's the offensive line. So Tucker had been in earlier at the center. Now he's joined by four new faces in the offensive line. Here's Hall again in the backfield, wrapped up. He got scrimmage. He'll be stopped at the 34 on a second down and 7. This will be the, well, we've just tied what we did against Louisiana Tech in the 88 game. We beat La Tech that day 56-17. At 56 right now. Here's McCowan from the pocket, throws off the fingertips of Spiller at the Aggie 38, incomplete. Standing at the 20, Leckler will take the snap from Kyle Ednicki as it goes down to the 14. Here's the return to the 20, to the 21, 22-yard line. First down and 10, Louisiana Tech.
Yeah, totally different challenges next week for A&M. Iowa State, a very proficient running team.
Martin from the 14 throws to Mackey at the 29, make it the 31-yard line. Second down and a yard. They're making some switches here as they move a wide out way out here to the left side. They move Mackey now to his right. Mackey drops back to a slot. Now a timeout will be called. So as we come back, Louisiana Tech at the line of scrimmage, second down. And about a yard, they'll throw to Mackey on the sideline at the far side of the field. And he's run out of bounds. There's a flag down. Somebody caught him by the face mask as he went out at the Louisiana Tech 39-yard line. So he'll get a first down, and then penalty yardage will be tacked on after the tackle. Checking some of these defensive players. For the most part, we're looking at mainly starters. They got Trent Driver out there now, and also we got Phillip Myers. Hand off in the backfield, coming back this way is Ragsdale across the 40, goes to about the 37. He'll pick up about 9 yards prior to his arrival at A&M. Here's the second down play. They pump once. Now they throw, and it's batted away. It was intended for down around the 13 for Francis Figueroa and Jones. 2 minutes, 10 seconds to go in the third. The Aggies ahead 56-6. And again on the ground there, trying for a first down. It's off to Ragsdale. Falls across the 35 to the 34. A minute 55 as the clock runs in the third quarter. 56-6 A&M. Play action, rolling back. Martin looking deep and almost intercepted by Rich Cody. He had number 4 in his sights, but just a little bit high. It was intended for the tight end. Second down and 10. Shotgun. Martin takes it, drops back to the 43, hit as he throws, and it is incomplete, and a flag will go down. 2 flags will go down. They're going to catch Trent Driver for defensive pass interference. 1 defensive pass interference, the call against A&M. So a first down for Louisiana Tech at the Aggie 29. Quick drop, pass Mackey, caught behind the line, advances it across the 25 to the 21 where he goes down. And it's Phillip Myers on the stop along with Sean Horn on the sideline. Second down and three. The ball spotted at the A&M 21 and a half. Two setbacks. And it will be a heavy eye. Play action from the 20. Throw it. And that's over the head of everybody. That was not a catchable pass. As we play our first game in the month of October. Audible at the line by
he'd better hurry.
Jason Martin. He's running out of time. He got it snapped with a second on the 25-second clock. Throws, batted up in the air by Trent Driver. Fourth down and three. Snap it. Drop back to the 30. Throw the ball. The tight end can't get to it. That was Bradley. Bradley stretching out. It goes incomplete. You'll get the club T-shirt, discounts to Aggie events, and free sports clinics. Kids Club benefits Special Olympics in the Brazos Valley. Here's McCowan throwing. Williams off his fingertips at the 24. Incomplete. Second down and 10. Williams is the lead back. He's flexed left side. The Aggies come out and show a light eye. The tailback is Dante Hall. McCowan. And it goes to Hall. We're trying the right side. He's across the 20 to the 25. He's out to the 29-yard line. Dante Hall just shy of the 30. Here's third down and two. Nose of the ball right at the Aggie 30 from the right hash mark. Eye formation. McCowan's the quarterback. Now a whistle, and the third quarter has just left us. So that one's history. We have one more quarter. 15 minutes of football left here at Kyle Field as the Aggies lead by a score of 56-6. I formation Texas A&M on a third down and about three from the Aggie 29-yard line. McCowan flips it to the right side to Hall. Hall runs through one would-be tackler and gets the ball to near the 35, and A&M has a first down. First down and 10 at the 35. On the ground once more. Hall breaks it right up the middle near the 40. Stopped at the 39-yard line. Randy McCowan has replaced Brandon Stewart at quarterback. He runs the offense now. He has a slot left. It's play action. He now rolls to his left, sets, throws, goes to the sideline, and it's been caught at the 39-yard line. That has been caught. We'll wait for him as they get up. That's Leroy Hodge. Hodge at the 39. 3 for 56 coming into play today. Leroy Hodge split in left, flanker right, tight end right, pitch it right. That's the tight end side around the corner. Hall, 30, has a lead block, uses it. He's out of bounds, and there is a flag down. I think they got us for holding. He went out at the 14-yard line. It will be holding against Texas A&M, Leroy Hodge. It's first down and about two from the 31-yard line. Ash to the right. Snap the ball, give it to Hall again. Oh, he's got a chance. He's going to score. Oh, ho, ho. He just went 31 yards. Dante Hall, 31 on the touchdown. Dante Hall, a freshman from Houston Nimitz. He has caught everybody's attention from the first day of the fall practices out on the Simpson Drill Field. Here's the extra points. It's good by Kyle Bryant.
That's Toya down there.
Just the slightest touch. With the index finger on top of the football. And remember, fans, he uses the bottom side of the kicking tee as Kyle Bryant. More kicking surface. Here's the cruise kick. It's end under end. Near side man at the 10. And they do the old end around bit again, and he's been caught. That's Edwards, and he'll be dropped down at the 16-yard line.
They got a 22-yard completion on a play action from Randy McCowan to Leroy Hodge to move into Louisiana Tech territory. Touchdown comes on a 31-yard runoff tackle by Dante Hall, 63-6.
Here is Martin throwing, and he throws to the sideline, and it's incomplete, trying to hit Mackey at the 25. Shotgun, take the snap, drop back to the 7. Step up as a flag flies, and the ball has been caught over the middle. That's Mackey, and oh, he paid for that.
And that was offsides against the Aggies, so this play will hold up.
Jason Martin has it. He relays that to his teammates. Got a new receiver. I think Hurd's checked back in. It's a draw out of the backfield as they have given it to Tell. Tell around the left corner and slung down at the 44-yard line. Not enough for a first down. Flag down here now at the 46-yard line side of the field.
Yeah, this will be offsides against the Aggies again. We lined up in the neutral zone.
No shotgun as they hand off and go straight ahead. The ball goes to the 50 on a first down and five. Second down and about two. They'll throw back to the right side. Mackey caught and he's down the sideline of the 40-35. Bumped out at the 34-yard line by Brandon Jennings out of Houston Channelview.
In defense of the Aggie defense, they're playing a zone coverage almost exclusively now with a 63-6 lead. But Martin and Mackey are something to watch.
And he's looking toward, now he's going to go deep. And he's down around the five. And that is caught and then dropped in the end zone. Second down and 10. At the Aggie 34-yard line, they go shotgun on this play. Straight drop. Going to throw on the flats to this side to Tell. Tell got an inside block. Now he cuts it back toward the near side hash mark, and he's brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Jimmy Irby is 6'2", 234. He is from Los Angeles Banning with the Mount San Antonio Junior College. In junior college day, he had 27 quarterback sacks. Straight drop out of a shotgun from the 45. Let's fly to the sideline. That's way out of bounds. Trying to hit Mackey down about the 5. Incomplete. Here's fourth down and 11. They'll go for it out of a shotgun. Martin drops back, throws it. It's been deflected up in the air, and it's incomplete. We're watching what could be a record-setting performance by an opposing quarterback. He has now thrown 53 times. He's 7 off the record. He stays in the game. He's likely to pass that. First down and 10. McCowan dropped the snap from center, picks it up. He'll be caught and dropped at the 35, maybe the 34. 42-6 at halftime. Here's a second down play, and it's Hall. Hall is bulldog down behind the line. He's dropped back at the 32-yard line. Cowan at the line of scrimmage on a third down at about 13 or 14. Drops back at the 25, forced out of the pocket, steps up, will run with the ball. Caught. First time missed it, and then the missed tackle. Then he gets it back to the 34. He picks up about 2 after all is said and done. So fourth down and punt time. Line of scrimmage is the 34. He'll stand at the 20. And the return man back at about the 19-yard line. We'll check it here in a moment. That's going to be short, however. And now we'll get an Aggie roll. Hit the 30 and goes to the 25, and it'll be killed there. So here is Martin. Perhaps a record-setting day on pass attempts against Texas A&M. However, they will go on the ground as they give the ball to Ragsdale, and he runs into a big traffic jam as he makes it to the 29-yard line. Second down and 6 after a 4-yard pickup by Ragsdale. Under center, Martin hands off again to Ragsdale. They try the left side, and they got the line of scrimmage, maybe a half yard from the 29 to the 29 and a half. Crowley and Myers on the stop. I want to remind all of you that Coach Slocum has his call-in show. It's on the air every Thursday night live from Chili's here in College Station. It airs from 7 until 8. You can call the coach at 1-800-927-9979 every Thursday night. Out of the shotgun. Drop back to the 20. Step forward to the 21. Throw in complete to the near sideline. And here is Dante Hall standing back at the A&M 33-yard line. Let's see what he does with this one. Lil with a nice wind at his back. Waits for the snap, standing at the 15. Line of scrimmage, we'll call it the 29. There's outside a little middle pressure. This is a nice kick. Hall backing up. We'll take it, and then is caught immediately and drug down. They'll give him the 20-yard line, and here is a flag coming out of nowhere at the Aggie 40, and it's going to be a face mask against Texas A&M. All right, Jason Bragg now will run at the fullback position.
Barry Johnson in at wide receiver.
Bragg is 6'3", 207, freshman, red shirt out of Stephenville. Excuse me. So out of the eye, long count by McCowan. They'll pitch it right to Hall. Turns the corner at the 10 and goes out of bounds at about the 14. 8:01 to go in the game. Second down and 5. Here's Barry Johnson, split out way left here on this side. And Bumgardner is to the right side on the ground. Hall bumps off one of his own men and now will cross the 15 and get it out to the 17. Hall to the 17-yard line. Third down and about 2. Again from the eye. Deep pitch to Hall. Bottled up for a moment. Now he breaks loose. And he's going to get it out to the 30, maybe the 35-yard line.
Wow. 12 rushes, 99 yards for Dante Hall.
What a nice day. He's on the verge of 100. Here's first down and 10 at the 35-yard line. Hall keeps this drive going, and they'll give it to Hall again. And he will get over 100 now as he goes to the 40. Five players have gone over 100. We've had 5 performances of 100 yards or better. 2 of those belong to Sir Parker. Here's second down and 5. Pitch it to the right. Good blocking. Here's Hall again. He'll get 2 more to add to his total. Here's the third down play. McCowan's the quarterback. The handoff goes to Hall. Hall hit in the middle. He's trying to get away. This time he will not slip away from Myron Smith. He's standing back at the 29. Wobbly kick off to the left side and will roll toward the sideline at the 29. It'll be killed there. Single setback lined up behind it. And now Burks will put this one in the air. And he's going deep. And he will overthrow his man at the Aggie 35-yard line intended for Larry Wright. 5:03 to go in the game. As this one has moved to over 3 hours old, here's the tight end. He'll catch the ball. That will be almost enough for a first down. That'll be near 10. La Tech will go 3-3. This will be the first time they have suffered a loss on the road this year. They'd gone 2-0. Now, at neutral site, they lost a ball game, but that was not at home. Here is the handoff. They go to the backfield, break a tackle, get it out to about the 50-yard line. That's enough for a first down. First down and 10. Throw it back this way. That will be caught, and it's going to be for about a 5-yard pickup. That'll be all. Ball will stay inbounds. Louisiana Tech comes to the line of scrimmage. They've been running from a regular formation. No shotgun so far for Burks takes the snap. They'll go on the ground again. Austin will take the handoff. He'll lose a half yard to the 45. So third down and 5. Slot to the left. Burks, 7-yard pocket. Throws. Caught by the tight end for a first down at the 38. Don't forget the ultimate tailgate party 3 hours prior to the game at the corner of George Bush and Welburn. I have some former athletes. We'll announce those folks on next week's broadcast. It's out signing autographs. Pitch right, short side of the formation. Austin behind the line and now back to the line of scrimmage at the 39. Second down and 10. They've gone to a shotgun. Drop the pocket back to the 46. Step up, throw. It will be caught for a first down at the 25-yard line.
Flags down, one in the backfield and one about the 43-yard line. We'll see the meaning of the flag. We're going to have offsetting penalties here. Offsides against the Aggies and holding against the Bulldogs.
So offsetting and second down and 10 again. Yell practice in Des Moines. Friday night, straight drop, regular formation, sort of a screen in the backfield, caught and then dropped. Bobby Raytel picks up about 3 after all said and done. From the Aggie 36-yard line, hope to go down to the locker room following the game and visit with some folks. Shotgun again, Burks drops back to the 45. He's letting fly here to the sideline. It's going to be caught, and it is a touchdown by Larry Wright. So now 63-12 before the point after. And the kick is up, and the kick is good. So 63-13. That's the first time they have scored since a field goal by Kent with no time as the first half ran out. They're going to try an onside kick. It's squirming around down there, and the Aggies have fallen on it at the 46-yard line. Those of you who are still in the stands, they'll hand off. They try the left side. That's going to be the first carry ever for Jason Bragg. Bragg running at the fullback position. So Leckler is running at quarterback at 6 rather than 4. And again, it goes to Bragg, and we've got 11 seconds, now 10 seconds. And Bragg picks up a first down. They'll let the time run out here, and A&M will win by a score of 63-13 over Louisiana Tech. They'll keep the record perfect as they go 5-0 against Louisiana Tech. So it's over with at Kyle Field. Stay tuned now for the postgame show. This is the Texas Aggie Network.
Oh, you know, we still are a young team now, but we are getting better. I've said all along I felt like we were making improvement. And, you know, going in the year, you'd like to be sitting here undefeated and have everything running smoothly and have a lot of experience, but we don't. So you take what we have and you say, I'm glad that we are getting better. And We have proven that there are some things that we can do with this team. I think if you look at the performance of our defense, it's obvious that we're getting better on defense. I thought Brandon Jennings today made several real good plays from the safety position. I thought offensively, you can see a lot of the parts of a good offense. We've demonstrated that we can run the ball some and we can throw it some, and I think we're getting closer to being what we would like to be in terms of, from an offensive standpoint, of having some balanced capabilities. I think so, Larry. I think it shows that we do have capabilities, and that if we protect the ball on offense and don't give up the big plays on defense and fly around, that there is enough ability there to be a pretty good team. And that's usually the way it is. Over the years, teams that are good teams, there are very few really talented teams that are far superior to other teams in talent. Usually it's pretty good teams who are doing all the little things well. They're not turning the ball over. They're taking the ball away. They're not giving up big plays. All those things that all of you know and that you hear so often that they become trite expressions by coaches. The reason why they're trite is because they're true. They've been said so many times, and they are true. You know, if you don't turn the ball over, you don't give up big plays, and you don't get a lot of penalties, then your chances of winning go up dramatically.